Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this altered clipboard, and it's a two-part video. I've actually already filmed how to apply the Mod Podge, and so you're going to see that at the tail end of this video. So I have gone ahead and cut the strip, but I'll go over that again. I've gone ahead and cut my designer paper. These are 2.5-inch strips, and this is 2-inch strips. And so I like to alternate using stripes and flowers. Now I'm going to go ahead and use my tape gun to apply these, because you're going to use Mod Podge to go over your clipboard. And so it's okay if you use a different adhesive under the clipboard. Okay, now I've put some thought into this. I've made sure that I have the chocolate up here at the top, because if you've watched my first altered clipboard video, I actually painted the clipboard, but if you can get by without painting it, that's even better. So once you Mod Podge this natural clipboard, it's going to darken it. And so, in my opinion, lining up this chocolate to the top up here just kind of makes it flow better. Okay, so there's the first piece. Okay, make sure I'm leaving just a little bit of space in there. Move this up a little. And the last one, and then we're going to start sanding. Okay. Sometimes I use glue sticks for this, but when I'm doing the video, I'll get glue all over my fingers, and it's just easier for me to use the tape gun when I'm filming. Okay, now I'm going to take my bone folder, and I'm just going to go across and make sure. You could also take your brayer. I just use my bone folder, and I make sure, you know, that there's really not any bubbles right now because I didn't use a wet adhesive, but I just want to make sure that I've sealed the adhesive, if that makes sense. Okay, so now I'm going to trim these pieces off here, and then I'm going to sand the edges. So I'm going to try to make sure that I stay in the camera view here. So I'm going to trim that little extra off. When it's a big piece like that, you want to go ahead and get rid of it. Those strips were, what did I cut them at? Well, I told you they were 2.5 by 9 was the other side. I didn't give you that measurement. Okay, so now we're going to sand. That looks good. Okay, get this out of the way. Remember to sand down, because you don't want to peel your cardstock back up. You could also come in here and sand this. You may not be able to see. This kind of gives it a little bit more of a worn look. It also kind of ties in your two papers. I don't know if you can, let's see. Can you tell where I sanded it here and sanded it here but not here? It kind of discolors it, so it makes it more antique-ish, I think. Last one. And then, of course, rough up your edges up here. Kind of tie that in. Okay, and at this point, I've sanded all the edges, and I think it's ready to go. It's ready to dry. You could also personalize this. If you've been watching my blog for a while, you've seen in the past, I have actually personalized these with people's names. So you could use your die cut system, and you could spell out someone's name. You could actually make this like a scrapbook page, and you could put some pictures on here and decorate it, and then Mod Podge it. Okay, this part of my video, I'm going to show you how to apply the Mod Podge to your clipboard. So what you're going to need, of course, is some Mod Podge, and I use the matte finish. I have used the glossy, and I don't know if you can see how that looks. I just kind of change it up depending on what I'm using it for. I also use these foam brushes, and I've had a lot of people ask me how to keep the bubbles out. And to be honest, I'm not real sure what the total secret is. I have a couple tips that I think do help, because as I'm looking at these, I don't have a trouble with bubbles. But I have seen some girls have that problem. Number one, when I make my clipboards, I usually wait at least 24 hours before I finish it. For example, this clipboard I made over a week ago, and I have not Mod Podged it yet. So now I know that the adhesive underneath here is completely dry. So I think that has a part to play with it. The second thing is that when I apply the strips of cardstock, I don't completely shove them up against each other. So I think sometimes the air bubbles come from you've layered your cardstock so tightly that the air bubbles get up underneath there. So if you could leave just a little hairline between there, it makes it easier. And I know on this one, it may look like I didn't leave a little bit of a line, but I did. And it's not that noticeable once you put the Mod Podge on there. That was three things. Use the foam brush instead of a paintbrush. Let it dry at least 24 hours from the time you apply your cardstock to your, then apply your Mod Podge, because the Mod Podge is the last thing you're going to do to it, unless you're going to add a photo, and then of course you would Mod Podge it again. And then to leave some space. So doing this, I'm just going to move this out of the way. Some of the things I like to have on hand, of course, is a little bowl with some water. Now, I didn't put water in it because I was afraid that I might flip this right in front of everybody and then ruin my clipboard. But I usually have a little bowl of water with my foam brush. I usually keep a bone folder and then the Mod Podge and also a wet wipe, because the glue gets really sticky, the Mod Podge, and I want to be able to get it off my fingers so that I don't transfer it to something else. Okay, so again, this is the Mod Podge, and I just open it up. I don't pour any out of here. This is actually a new bottle. But I just dip right in here. Okay, hopefully you can see that. And I just start out with a little bit. And then I just start on one side and go across. If you'll notice as I'm applying this, I did make sure that I got it in between those cracks between the designer paper. Now someone asked, does this little clip stick? You know what? It doesn't. I'm not really sure why it doesn't, but it doesn't. So you don't have to worry about, you know, propping that up and keeping it from sticking. It doesn't stick. Okay, so here's the tricky part. You probably should apply this before your ribbon. One more. I had a little bit too much on my brush that time. Okay, I think it looks good. Might want to get off some of this extra here, since I applied too much. It looks a little whitish, but it dries clear. And then you might want to make sure that you kind of go down the sides and that you have your edges sealed. But if you do that, well, let me show you. I'm going to make sure my edges are done. And then I'm going to come back and just kind of like you're painting your wall, you know, just kind of blend it in. Okay, so there it is. I'm going to let this dry for about 24 hours. I know you don't see any, I don't see any air bubbles at all. Not that they couldn't pop up later, but I think that those three tips that I gave you eliminate any air bubbles. So if you have any questions, just let me know. Thanks.